everyone has just like really stepped up. Like everyone knows that, I don't know, like there's nothing to lose. Like there's nothing to lose. Like you running those extra 20 yards as fast as you can, like there's nothing to lose. So like why not just do it?
It's just those small things that our team does that we just know each other so well, and we play to each other's strengths, and we're willing to do anything we need to make sure everyone feels comfortable and confident like on the field at that time.
It's not always about like the biggest, greatest plays. It's like the little things and the in-between the lines hustle plays. So it's not even like a question, or it's not hard for anyone on our team to, you know, give the extra hustle to sprint to get a ball or a turnover.
We've really had a heavy focus on the thing that you can control every time you step foot on that field is your intensity, your focus, your effort, and your attitude. And that is played out in those 50-50 balls, center draws, ground balls, the ride and getting that ball back and hustling. I think the neat thing is to see them do it and kind of hunt in packs and to be there supporting each other. There's no person that's kind of back in the back of the pack, not holding up their end of the bargain. So it's just a level of intensity, and it's not game day. It's actually built from within our practices.
I think the season has been a super exciting one and never a dull moment. The biggest thing you can really be proud of with this team is just the resilience that we've seen from the beginning to where we're at right now. There's been so much character, so many things we've had to overcome, but the biggest thing is the most important season is yet to come.
As the season's going on, like I just feel a lot more comfortable in the offense, and it's a really free-moving offense, so it's easy to just jump in and make connections with other players.
I think not being able to play last year and finally being on the field, it's just you can feel the energy from everyone and just the confidence that's spreading around just from the bench, from the coaches, like the sideline, everyone on the field. You just have so much confidence, but we're so calm about it, and we know we're not like shocked. We're just, I think we all know how good we are, and I think we're all starting to really believe.
Coming into the season, I knew that something had to change from last season. Just the whole team, I think we felt something that like something needed to be done, and like we needed to change our attitudes, change our like our whole mindset, change like what we're doing on the field, what we're doing off the field. And the team like so far has done that, and we've like kind of stuck to our standards.
I think it all comes down to accountability. Jen said it herself. She holds the same standards for the first person on the field to the last person on the field. And I think that's something that stuck with me, because I think she's right. It's no matter who you are, no matter how much playing time you get, I think we all should hold ourselves equally accountable.
Kind of our like motto for the season is finish the fight. So it's not a focus on the past. It's now like this year in our team. So I think while obviously we want to get revenge on Navy and, you know, all of our losses last year, I think it's more of a focus on us internally, what we can do to control the future and our success.
We've been preparing in the same way for every team. We focus on the scout, we focus on what we need to do to beat that team, we focus on what we need to do to highlight our strengths and mitigate some of our weaknesses in some ways against these teams. And so we'll continue to do that. It's not about who we're stepping out to play that day. It's, you know, what does Loyola lacrosse need to do in that day, in that moment? So nothing will change for us this week of practice. Obviously on the coaching side of things, you know, scouting wise, we need to prepare for two games within the span of 3 days. So that changes a little bit, but the preparation for the team and the way in which we go about it will be no different.
A big part of why we've been so successful early on in the season has a lot to do with our leadership group and our four captains that we have. And what Jen's been doing this season is meeting with them once a week, every Monday, to kickstart that week. What are our goals? What do we need to work on? How do we need to reach out to certain players on the team? How can we continue to build one another up? And just looking at that leadership as just as important as lifting, conditioning, and our stick work.
So far in the Patriot League, I feel like we've done our job, and we've kind of shown teams like we are in the top 10, like we're here to compete. But I also think that there's so much more to Patriot League games, and like even though we're not playing teams that aren't necessarily ranked, like it kind of shows like a more creative Loyola side.
Yeah, I think our defensive unit in the Patriot League has obviously been great. I think something so awesome about being in a Patriot League is that there's such a widespread of talent across every team we play, which challenges us to know. Like Jen always talks about us even though we can get the result we want in a win, it doesn't really mean anything if we didn't play the full 60 minutes to our best, like the Loyola lacrosse that we all know we can play. And I think our defense especially has been really staying true to that and staying at the standard that we set for ourselves.
You know, in these last two games, I've really seen our team grind out defense, and they've been tough, and they've been disciplined, and they've been connected. And I think we're just not giving teams good looks, and I think that's really key in a good defense.
Yeah, Loyola's defense has always been historically our first line of attack. So as far as how they've been playing, it's been no surprise to us. We've just been very excited about just the depth that we have back there, whether it's a midfielder matching up or a matchup defender or just someone playing more of a versatile role back there, helping clearing the ball.
Defensively, we have had many people step up into roles that they have never had to fulfill before, and I think that has been a big part of our defense.
We knew within ourselves we had the talent and potential this year, but it's a different thing when season starts and kind of if you can manifest that talent. So, I mean, it's just awesome. Like, I smile when I just think about how we're doing so far, but it's still so early on that it doesn't not matter, but it doesn't matter what we've done. It's now what we're gonna keep doing, and that's what people are gonna remember and what's gonna really matter.
You know, draw controls at any point of who you're playing and where you're at in your season is so crucial. If you don't have the ball, you're not going to be able to score. You're not going to be able to get into an offensive rhythm. And for those matchups that we're going to see in Syracuse and Navy, those teams bring a lot of energy by getting those draw controls and pushing those fast break opportunities. So if we want to win those games, we need to win that circle battle, and we need to win that individual draw battle as well.
I always tell Taylor I fangirl her so much, because she is just so good, and I think it's just so awesome playing with her, especially being on the draw team with her. And I think she has so much knowledge of the game that she just kind of knows where everyone is, and it's something that you can't really explain how we play with each other. It's just we kind of just know where each other are gonna be.
I didn't have much, like, no one ever taught me really how to take the draw. Like, my sister took it in college, but coming in here, Dana really just like took over, and we used to do draw stuff like every day in the fall, my freshman year. I mean, telling you, I did so many individuals, probably more than anyone on the entire team for their whole 4 years that they've been here. And it was something that really helped. And I think Dana putting that time and effort into a player like me, it just like is incredible that she could do that.
You know, I'm not sure there's a better draw specialist or coach person that can play the game at such a high level, but teach and coach it at the level that Dana does. It blows my mind. These girls are so incredibly lucky. I feel extremely grateful that I have her on my side and not having to go up against her, because she's just a mastermind of the game in the middle. She's really changed the way that game can be played, and at such an important position like the center draw, where technically it's supposed to be a 50-50 every time you go in there, when you can coach players, but as well team, the team in general, to cohesively work to win you that draw and change that into your favor, I mean, you're a leg up on any opponent that you face.
When we do individuals, she will demo something, and she will literally do it to 110%, like perfect it, and I'm gonna have to do it, and I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm like, I have to do that, like I have to do what she just did, and I'm like, I don't know how I'm gonna do that. So I think like when she does things like that, it just like inspires me, and I'm like, wow, like I can do this, like she did this, like I need to be as good as her. Yeah, when every time I go up against Dana, like every time I do something with Dana, like she's always working her hardest with me. And I think it's just like crazy that she can be a coach and still wanna be like making me the best player. But I think it's more than just draws too. I think the whole creativity side, I think that Dana has really helped me with. And like even when we do individuals, she brings stick work into draws. And I think that's really helped me.
I think a lot of the people who get unnoticed are those circle players. So anytime you see a center being able to win to themselves, that comes off their circle players boxing out, giving that time in that room. So I think I'm really, really proud to see Hannah Powers working so well with those guys in the middle, Lindsay Earhart coming up with balls on the ground or in the air, and just being so desperate to make sure that, you know, whatever it takes, they're gaining that possession for their team.
I think it gives us a big advantage to have multiple people that can be on the circle, just because like not it's like you're always having fresh legs, but you're always having like a fresh mind in there. In the BU game, we had Gamer who hadn't been on the circle probably all year. She came in and she got a draw control. So So I think it's just, we have all these players that are just excited to play, and no matter who's on there, like, they're gonna try their best to get the ball.
Going into the game and during the game, last year there was just like this sense of like, it was kind of taken for granted or assumed that we were gonna win and beat every single team we played. And I think that's why when the first whistle blew in the game, it was just like a sense of complacency.
I think we definitely got complacent last year. And not taking anything away from Navy because they're great. But I think we took it
for granted.
I think this weekend's huge just for women's lacrosse. I think women's lacrosse can get a bad rep from sometimes for not being aggressive enough, slow pace, moving. But with these two games coming up, I think people are gonna see what like women's lacrosse is really all about. I think, especially through our style of play, the way we transition the ball, the way we move the ball, our aggressive defense, I think that's what people wanna see. And I think when people watch these games, it's like, well, one, it's really inspiring to young girls that wanna be kinda just like us. They wanna play like in the atmosphere that we do. And just for people that might be skeptical of the women's game in general, I think once they do see these games, they're gonna be like, okay, this is how it should be and this is what it's like.
You can't forget, you know, what it's taken to get to where we are right now. And the biggest games are yet to come. So if we can continue to push ourselves, push one another, and just make sure we're doing everything we can each and every day to be the best team that we can possibly be, I think that next step will take care of itself.
I was watching the game last year when they lost. And ever since then I was like, oh, we have to win that next year. And then coming here and knowing like the people who actually went through it and seeing how motivated they are to win that game, I'm just really excited for this weekend.
The timing of it all is really exciting. You know, it's just like a national championship weekend. So that's kind of how I'm looking at it. You know, we have Syracuse Thursday, Navy Saturday, huge games and both huge rivalries. I think that's what I'm most looking forward to, and especially Navy. Going back to Navy again after losing to them, I think we're all just so fired up and ready for that game. And I think I like how the coaches lined it up for us. I think it's really good for us to have two back-to-back games, not a lot of time in between, because I think we all know that that's what's gonna be like come postseason play.